នៅ ប្រទេស កម្ពុជា ក្រោយ ពី ការ បោះ ឆ្នោត ជា សកល នៅ ឆ្នាំ 1993 គឺ ថា អ្នក វិនិយោគ បាន ចូល មក ប្រទេស កម្ពុជា ច្រើន
At that point of time there were no factories here, there were no employers, organizations, there were no trade unions to speak of. The Cambodian garment industry is really the first step towards industrialization.
Nowadays, most export factories produce for well-known US and European brands, including H&M, Gap, Adidas, and Levi's. Garment exports are now Cambodia's top foreign currency earner.
But I would say that in Cambodia, the factories are, you know, a bit notch above as far as it comes to social compliance. And that is one of the reasons here for us to come here.
We export 2.8 billion. We are the 11th biggest supplier in the United States, which I think we succeed very nicely.
ដល់ 50% 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 ដ រូបខ្ញុំនេះឯងត្រូវបានគេឆក់ធ្វើឲ្យខ្លួនប្រាណរបស់យើងខ្ញុំនឹងមិនមានកាយសម្បទាមួយមួយនេះ
វិស័យកាត់ដេរជាវិស័យមួយដែលមានលក្ខណៈស្រួយហើយស្រើបស្រាលណាស់គេថា sensitive ពីព្រោះគេថាឲ្យទៅមានបញ្ហាអីដែលធ្វើឲ្យគេលំបាកដល់អ្នកវិនិយោគអ្នកវិនិយោគគេនឹងវិចប្រវិចចេញទៅវិញស្រួលណាស់
The worldwide financial crisis has caused huge damage to Cambodia's garment manufacturing sector. In 2009, with some 70 factories closing, almost 20% of the workforce lost their jobs.
I think the crisis, it gives an opportunity to grow, no? It gives an opportunity to invest in those areas where there are gaps.
I think Cambodia stands there as a competitive country, and so I think it's going to have a very good and positive future in terms of the garment industry.
The industry cannot stay still. It needs to move up the value chain.
It is especially important to not only preserve the jobs in the industry, but also to uphold decent wages and decent working conditions to allow for a good livelihood for the workers.